now you can sit.
Sit.
Excuse me, you can sit. First of all, Jazakumullah khair. You are coming, all of you to come to welcome us. Jazakumullah khair. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min shahli sadri. Rabbi yassir li amri wa shahli sadri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Jazakumullah khair again. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Talking about Hajj is not an easy topic, but Hajj, alhamdulillah, is a unique experience for me. And in short, I can say is Hajj make person closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to talk about Hajj, maybe alhamdulillah, Imam give us a brief talk about Hajj and also in his Salah he recited Surah Al-Hajj. But my talk is going to start by Taysir. If Allah make Taysir for you to go to Hajj, then you can go to Hajj. And Taysir means in English, Allah to make it easier for you. Beginning, I'd like to start that myself, I plan too many planning to go to Hajj, and on only one plan is get success. And here also, I'm going to tell you about the power of da'wah to make a dua. I remember that I did too many plans for a long time, but it doesn't get success. Last year and this year, but before the Hajj 15 days ago, I remember Imam Jazakallah Khair, he sent me a message. And in that, maybe he didn't know Imam, but in that message is a hadith. That hadith will, you know, in short, is the meaning of that hadith. If you wake up in the middle of the night for any reasons, you need to say that dua is a hadith sahih from Al-Bukhari, which is, you need to say, if you wake up in the middle of the night, before you don't need to do wudu, not anything, just say that dua, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, wa la hawla wa la ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And then you need to say again also subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa alhamdulillah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And then say rabbi aghfir li. And then if you add to that if you go and do wudu and do two rak'ah, then do pray and then make any dua, Allah can accept it. When I get that message from Imam, suddenly I wake up in the middle of the night and I did that dua. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa wahdahu la sharika lah. له الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Then I make dua, oh Allah, give me the opportunity to go to
Hajj
this year inshallah. And الحمد لله that the following day straight away I get, you know, the proof that the process is starting of my Hajj, my journey to Hajj. Alhamdulillah. And within 1 week, everything is being done, cutting the ticket and the immunization and all other things. And, so this is I mean, here the fairest comes the taysir. Alhamdulillah, taysir comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yes, then the next step is when you go to Hajj, there's too many things you can say. But first, you know, the Hajj is something between you, between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something you can say it, something you can't say it. But myself, I get, alhamdulillah, too many things become easier for you when you go to Hajj. Too many things will get easier for you. Allah will make it easier for you, your journey will become easier. And alhamdulillah, we found a group of friends and people. We share that unique experience together. And alhamdulillah, we did Umrah. When you come, when you been there, you get the chance to do the tamattu, to do the qiran, to do you get three kind of hajj, or you make it ifrat. So we did the tamattu, which is you start umrah and then make tahallul, and then start again doing the hajj. Alhamdulillah, we did that. We did tamattu because we arrived there on 12th of August. We arrived there 13th of August, and from 13th of August, which is the second day of Hajj, second of Zulhijjah, until the 8th of Zulhijjah, we got the chance to make tahallul and make program. So our main program is to be linked or to be connected with the haram. And alhamdulillah, we used to have a plan that we used to live in area a little bit far away from the haram. But it's our plan all the time, just to make sure that we are, you know, to program with haram all the time. So we wake up early, maybe 3 at night. We prepare ourselves to go to Fajr and do Fajr there, stay there, read Quran, and then make duha, and coming back again, and again we'll go back on Maghrib and Isha. That program continue until the day of Tarwiyah. The day of Tarwiyah is the 8th of Zulhijjah, and the 8th of Zulhijjah is the beginning of to learn about Hajj, you know, to learn. To learn in between you and you know, to learn about Hajj and the value of Hajj, starting from the day of Tarwiyah. The day of Tarwiyah is subhanallah, Islam is will go in steps. So the day of Tarwiyah is a sunnah, but Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion, he did that day of Tarwiyah to prepare himself for the day of Arafah, which is before the day of Arafah. So the day of Tarwiyah, all the Hajj will go to Mina and sit there in Mina all the day from Fajr until Isha time, until Fajr to the next day. Just sitting there, preparing themselves emotionally and physically all the difficult days coming, which is day of Arafah, and then the day of Rabi al-Aqaba al-Kubra, and then the Rabi al-Jamarat, the 9th of Muzdalifah before that. And alhamdulillah, so the hikmah here of the day of Tarwiyah is people will get relaxed and sit and read Quran, and just you know, face, relax there, face to the sky, maybe malaika sozam or something. Alhamdulillah, we did that, alhamdulillah. And the day of Arafah is a day we can learn a lot from it. Myself, I learn a lot from the day of Arafah. The day of Arafah is the day I can say that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Al-Hajj Arafah. So if you come to Arafah, then your Hajj will be full. Otherwise, if no Arafah for you, no Hajj for you. And the day of Arafah actually is a zikr and dua day. And that's what I did after Zawal. Before Zawal, most of the people maybe they started from the beginning, but for the people they got advice, they started after Zawal, mean after doing Zuhr and Asr, Jam' al Taqdeem. Then you stand up in Arafah and make a dua and zikr. And actually, alhamdulillah, the day of Arafah, after Zawal, any minute you can see like a minute going away from you. If you didn't capture that minute, then you're not going to find it anyway, anymore. So the day of Arafah, after Zawal, keep making, alhamdulillah, you keep making dua and zikr and some adhiya from the Quran. And until the sunset, even you can feel, you don't like that sun to go away, because still you feel like you have more dua, more zikr you need to say. But alhamdulillah, is a chance between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make istighfar and to make tawbah and to start moving. Actually, this is affecting me about alhamdulillah. The day of Arafah is the day, actually, any Muslim hope to stand up there. It's a great day. If it's the Laylatul Qadr, it's a great night. Laylat is a day of Arafah, it's a great day. And any Hajj advice, go there, you need to plan, very good planning for the day of Arafah. The day of Arafah is day also we can learn. That means, as Allah said in the Quran, Yawm al-Hajr al-Asghar. This is a small day of Qiyamah. It is an example of Qiyamah. It teaches you how people can stand up in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day like that. And you can see millions of people standing up and wearing the same wearing. That shows you also the unity. And show you the unity. But at the same time, it will be very sad because unity has been lost. You see all Muslims around maybe more than 3 million standing up in one place saying, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, Labbaik La Sharika Lak Labbaik, Inna Alhamda Wa Ni'mata Lak Wal Mulk La Sharika Lak. The same voice, all of them. So, the day of Arafah is a day to us to learn and to get it as a real opportunity. For those people that are standing up in Arafah. Even the Saudi make it easy. For those people get sick, get heart attack in the hospital. They bring them by helicopter, will put them down just for a few moments, and they will take them back. Just to let them get the chance of standing up in the Arafah line. And alhamdulillah, that is after Arafah, we've been to Muzdalifah. And Muzdalifah has another lesson for us to learn, which is all the people sleeping in the ground, very close to each other in Muzdalifah, the night of Muzdalifah, also the Sunnah, the night of Muzdalifah. That will show you we are, the human being come from the earth and we go back to the earth. And at the same time, show you too many human beings just sleeping in the floor, in the ground without any shelter, without any houses. We'll teach us that. Muzdalifah night. And in the early morning of Al-Eid, Al-Adha, people, all of them, they will go to Rabi' al-Aqaba al-Kubra. And Ramiyat al-Aqaba al-Kubra is very emotional for me as well, because you see how people, too many people going the same direction, all of them, a lot of people from too many nationalities, all of constantly going for the same purpose, which is to do the Jamrat al-Aqab al-Kubra, which is to throw the stone into the shaitan. It's not a real shaitan there, but is like an example, or like as Imam said one day, is like saying no more combining shaitan from now on, and this is tawbah like that. And you got the chance to make a dua in Rabi' al-Aqab al-Kubra. I don't like to take too many time of taking it step by step, but what I'm going to say is Hajj. In Hajj, you got the opportunity to make a dua. You got the opportunity also to do good deeds as well. It's not just performing the wajib and the arkan and the sunnah, also to make good deed, like doing sadaqah and helping people. I remember me and my other two colleagues in the day of Jamrat al-Aqab al-Kubra. We've been going to do the Rami Jamra, and we saw from far away old man, very old man. He's going opposite to the direction. People going this way and he's going, and he's very tired. He's nearly gonna fall down. And that means he's lost his way, or he's getting something wrong. Straight away, when I saw that, I told to my two colleagues, let's go to that man and help him. And we've been there, and we asked him. He's old man from Tunisia. We talked to him in Arabic. Hal anta bakhayr? And he said, I lost my group. And he's very old. He nearly gonna fall down. And one of us, me and I, hold him from one hand, and the other one, as a colleague, hold him from the other hand. We took him to the guard. And we told him he lost his groups. And the good thing is, you got a sticker in your hand. From that sticker, they can identify from which group you are. And we left him in the right place and in safe hand. Alhamdulillah. So I'm saying that is because in Hajj you need to perform a Hajj, and at the same time you need to do good deed there. And in Hajj also you need to make whatever you can, salah is good too. We've been myself, you know, first time when I see the Kaaba, I can't describe that emotion, but Kaaba will make you feel like, alhamdulillah, I am here now standing up in front of Kaaba doing salah, and I imagine at the same time how many million people now doing the salah at the same time in this direction. And I'm very close to that Kaaba. Will come feeling like that come to me, alhamdulillah. And that is a good opportunity when you make tawaf in Kaaba also to do dua and to do zikr. So finally, I would like to say that is before you go to Hajj, you need to, this is a bit short advice, before you go to Hajj, you need to make the intention first, and second, you need to learn a little bit about Hajj. There's some booklet, because to perform a Hajj, you can make a mistake there if you didn't learn. For example, me and my colleague, we come to do when we did the Umrah, we come to the Sa'i and Tawaf area, we did 14 shots instead of doing 7 shots, because this is due to jahl, you know, of that nusra. So when we did start from Safa to Marwa, and from Marwa to Safa, we consider it as a one shot, but it's two shots. We learn later on, but alhamdulillah, is fine because it's jahl from us, we don't know about that. So what I'm trying to say here, you're planning to go to Hajj at least, learn about Hajj. Learn about Hajj and get some advice. And we, alhamdulillah, us, we perform Hajj, we are happy next year to help people if they want help, we'll give them advice. Jazakumullah khair.
Salaam.